The province's leaders have debated in this building for more than a century. Tonight, we bring the debate to the legislature in Regina as leaders argue the issues at the core of this election campaign. Good evening. Bonsoir et bienvenue. Danse, Nawagumagantik, Kititem Scott Nawau. And greetings and welcome to the 2024 Saskatchewan Leaders Debate. I'm your moderator, Marelda Fidler-Potter, assistant professor at First Nations University of Canada and journalist. We are in the provincial legislature, located on Treaty 4 territory, the original lands of the Cree, Soto, Dakota, Lakota, Nakota, and homeland of the Métis. The leaders of the two official parties who were elected under their party's banner and hold seats have been invited to go head-to-head on many important topics. So what comes next? Saskatchewan voters will decide when they cast their ballots on October 28th. This multi-platform live broadcast has been organized by a consortium, including CBC, CTV, and Global. Let's introduce the two leaders taking part. Scott Moe is the leader of the Saskatchewan Party. And Carla Beck is the leader of the New Democratic Party. Thank you both for being here. Now to our panel of journalists asking the questions. Adam Hunter is CBC Saskatchewan's provincial affairs reporter. Brendan Purdy is an anchor with Global News. Allison Bamford is a national reporter with CTV News. And Murray Mandrick is a columnist for Post Media, which includes the Leader Post and Star Phoenix. Here are the rules. Each leader has 2 minutes to make their opening statement. After that, reporters will ask their questions, and the leaders will have 45 seconds to respond without being interrupted. Then there will be a 3-minute debate on the same topic. To keep things on track, I will interject, if necessary, and cut people off. At the end, each candidate will have a 2-minute closing statement. So let's get started. We held a random draw to decide who would kick us off tonight. The NDP won the draw. So Leader Carla Beck, your 2 minutes starts now.
Good evening, Saskatchewan. The province I grew up in was a place where people looked out for one another. On the farm, we relied on our neighbors, and our neighbors relied on us. This is a province where people can set aside differences to get things done. But Scott Moe and the Sask Party have taken us from leaders to laggards on issue after issue. And Saskatchewan people are looking for change. I hear it from seniors struggling to pay for the basics, like rent and groceries. I hear it from women forced to leave our province just to get basic health care. They all say it's time for change. Now, I've been laying out our plan, a plan to make life more affordable and to get us out of last place in education and health care. A plan to cut the fuel tax and remove the PST from kids' clothing and from groceries. A plan to invest in our kids' classrooms and ensure that every child has the chance at that best education. A plan to hire more doctors and nurses so that you can get the care you need when and where you need it. I see opportunity in every corner of this province. But under Scott Moe and the Sask Party, there's too much opportunity being left on the table and too many Saskatchewan people being left behind. It doesn't have to be this way. This election, you have a choice. You can vote for more of the same. More hours spent waiting in ERs. More overworked doctors and nurses. More people dying, waiting to get the care that they need. Or you can vote for change. I'm Carla Beck. I'm running to be your premier. And this election, I'm asking for your vote. It's time for Saskatchewan to lead again.
Thank you, Ms. Beck. Now let's turn to Saskatchewan Party Leader Scott Moe.
Well, thank you, Marilda, and good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us this evening in our provincial legislature. Tonight, you are going to hear two very different plans. The Saskatchewan Party has a plan for a strong economy and for a bright future. Saskatchewan has come so far the last number of years, and our plan is to build on that record of growth. It's a plan to ensure that that growth continues. creating more good jobs and opportunities for Saskatchewan people, and in particular for our children. It's a plan to keep making investments in the things that a growing province needs. More teachers, more doctors, more nurses, new hospitals and new schools, more police officers and recovery centers so that we can keep our communities safe. It's a plan to make life more affordable for students, for seniors, for homeowners, for families, and for everyone. And that is one large difference between the two plans that you'll see here this evening. The Saskatchewan Party wants to lower your taxes and put more money back into your pockets so that you can decide how to spend it. The NDP wants to take more of your hard-earned money so that they can spend it. And that's an important difference that you will see here this evening. I'm so proud of our province and all that we have been able to achieve together. We have come so far since the dark days of decline, loss, and closure under the NDP. So I look forward to discussing the Saskatchewan Party's plan for a strong economy and a brighter future. And once again, thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you, leaders. It's time to go to our panel for the first question tonight, starting with CBC's provincial affairs reporter, Adam Hunter. Adam?
Ms. Beck, we'll start with you. Healthcare has been a major campaign issue. We've seen nurses rally outside of this building early on in the campaign. We've also seen reports of ERs being over capacity and people are struggling to find a family doctor. I'd like to know how your plan for healthcare is better than your opponent's.
Let's be clear. Our healthcare system is broken. Scott Moe and the Sask Party broke it. They can't be trusted to fix it. We hear heartbreaking stories every day about people in this province not able to get the care that they need. We see people dying on wait lists before they get the care that they need. We've got a plan. I don't have a magic wand, but we do have a plan that invests in the valuable healthcare workers that we need in this province, retains the one that we have, the ones that we have, a plan that's been built with them. A plan to grow your own, to encourage more people to get into healthcare. A plan to get us out of last place when
your
it comes
time is
to
up,
healthcare.
Ms. Beck. Thank you. Now let's turn to Mr. Moe.
Well, first I would say the challenges that we're seeing in healthcare across Canada are just that. They're not exclusive to Saskatchewan. They are a Canadian challenge. And they are challenges that require investment. $1.8 billion of investment over the last 4 years, an almost 11% investment in healthcare this last year. Investment to expand our healthcare infrastructure and to look at innovative new ways to deliver healthcare. Urgent care centers come to mind. To expand the number of surgeries that we are doing using all of the tools that are available to us, but most importantly, invest in our people with the most ambitious health human resource plan in the nation of Canada. So I would say thank you to the healthcare workers. This is a party that will provide more doctors, more nurses, more training spaces, more hospitals, but also acknowledge we have more
thank
work
you,
to
Mr.
do.
Thank you, Mr. Moe.
Mr. Moe,
it's now time for our first open debate of the night. I know you're both eager, and we are eager to hear you both as well. You now have 3 minutes for open debate.
Mr. Moe wants to thank healthcare workers now while he's standing here in this debate. The reality is he didn't even have the respect to talk to nurses who are raising concerns about safe staffing levels, about the level of care and the danger of our overcrowded emergency rooms in this province. Scott Moe and the Sask Party talk about how much they spend. Let's look at results. Scott Moe says he wants to run on his record. Let's look at his record. The longest wait lists for surgery in the entire country. The most people dying on wait lists in this province. Women with lumps in their breast deciding whether they can pay out of pocket and go out of province to get the healthcare they need or risk dying on those longest in Canada wait times. It doesn't have to be this way. There's no magic wand. This is going to be hard work. But we've got a plan to get us out of last place, to work with healthcare workers to turn around those record number of healthcare workers leaving our province. It's a plan to invest in doctors and nurses. Scott Moe's plan has no increases to hire additional doctors and nurses in this province. With all due respect,
when it comes to hiring physicians and nurses, about 800 more physicians and nurses alone, never mind the other healthcare professionals that are working in our healthcare system today. 1,800 nurses have been hired in the last 18 months and are working in and offering services in a Saskatchewan facility today. Our record the last 4 years is $1.8 billion. The NDP platform moving forward is $1.1 billion, which is actually a cut to what the record of the Saskatchewan Party has been the last 4 years. In that $1.1 billion, there's $685 million that actually isn't in their costing platform. And so when the NDP candidate arrives on your doorstep, I would ask them, why are they cutting health care in the province of Saskatchewan? Why are they not investing in a record number of surgeries like we did this last year? The surgical wait time in Saskatchewan is actually lower than it was in 2007, despite 250,000 additional people living here today. That being said, there is more work to do. There is more work to do on healthcare, on education, and so many files and services and that are important to Saskatchewan people. And this is a party that is running on the record that we have to ensure that we are ready to do that work on your behalf.
Let's look at your record. You're talking about how many you've hired. You're not talking about the fact that 4,000 healthcare workers in this province left last year alone. People are dying on
our
waitlist.
There's over 40,000 people working in the healthcare system.
People cannot get the care that
they
need. People cannot get ambulances to arrive in time. There's a woman in Saskatoon, a woman named Sharon, who had to wait for over an hour with symptoms of a heart attack because there was no ambulance. They were stuck in overcrowded emergency rooms and offload delays. You deserve better than this.
Time is up for that debate. Let's go back to Adam for another question.
Mr. Moe, this is for you to start off. The costs of everything seems to be going up, from gas to groceries to rent. What are you proposing to do to deal with affordability concerns in the first year of your mandate?
Well, I would say first and foremost, today, Saskatchewan is the most affordable place in Canada to live. And we have the lowest inflation rate, largely because we removed the carbon tax from the way that we heat our homes in this province. That low inflation rate is helping, but we do understand that Canadian families and Saskatchewan families are feeling the cost of living pressures that we are seeing across this nation. When you look at the platform that we had brought forward, to increase the graduate retention program by 20%. It's a platform, and the income tax reductions that will impact everyone in the province of Saskatchewan. It is a platform that most certainly is increasing benefits and lowering taxes for students, for seniors, for homeowners, for families, and for everyone that lives in this province, and will act on it quickly if we are elected your government.
Thank you, Mr. Moe. Let's go to Ms. Beck. You have 45 seconds.
This is one of the number one issues we hear on the doorstep, and I hear it from people all the time. Losing sleep, worrying about how they're going to pay their bills. I hear from parents who are worried that they're not going to be able to put their kids in dance or in hockey this fall because of the cost of living in this province. The reality is Scott Moe has done nothing before tonight to offer any affordability relief. In fact, he made things worse. He raised taxes 31 times in 1 year. We've heard you. We've got a plan to put more money in your pocket, and we're going to do it by Christmas. Cutting the fuel tax on day one, removing the PST from kids' clothing and groceries. We've got a plan to give families a break on the cost of living.
Thank you. That is it for the individual answers. I'll just repeat the question before we go into our 3-minute open debate. The cost of almost everything is going up, from gas to groceries to rent. What are you going to do to address affordability concerns in the first year of your mandate? And let's add some specifics for our voters tonight.
Scott Moe is standing here in this debate tonight, telling you he's going to make your life more affordable. 4 years ago, he stood in this same debate. He promised to reduce your power bills by 10%, and then he raised them 3 times. He promised no new taxes, and he raised them 31 times in 1 year. He also promised to balance the budget, something he hasn't been great at either. We've got a plan. We've heard you. We understand how important this is to families to have some money in their pocket right away. That's why we're going to cut the fuel tax, remove the PST that Scott Moe put on kids' clothes and groceries. We've got a plan to control rent in this province to ensure that we don't see what we see right now in this province, which is the highest year-over-year rent increase in the country. We've got a plan to offer a nutrition program for kids in schools. Our plan will deliver 2 times the relief to Saskatchewan families next year compared to Scott Moe's plan.
The last 2 budgets in the province of Saskatchewan are balanced by the provincial auditor statement, not by anyone else,
you
but the provincial auditor statement says the last 2 budgets in this province were balanced. We are reducing the cost of living for Saskatchewan people, or have been as a government, by removing the carbon tax off of the fuel that you heat your home with. We have $2 billion in each and every budget that is leading to Saskatchewan being the most affordable place in Canada to live today, with the lowest inflationary rate due to cutting that carbon tax from your home heating fuel. Add to that the income tax savings over the next 4 years, going to save $3,400. Add to that the expanded graduate retention program. Add to that increasing the low income tax credit. Saskatchewan will remain the lowest, the most affordable place in Canada to live. That is the goal of the Saskatchewan Party. There are measures that are in place today, and there's measures that will be in place should we form government on October the 28th. Unlike the NDP party that has put forward a platform that simply had grabbed $800 million out of thin air. No one can explain where it came. Not the economist on the evening news is not able to explain where their dollars, where that $800 million come from. And so when this is the NDP candidate comes to your door to ask for your support, ask them where the $800 million fictional dollars that they grab from thin air are in their budget, because I would say,
Mr. Moe,
at the end of the day, they don't have any intention on balancing the budget. They are going to raise taxes, and that means that you're going to balance the budget for it.
I'll remind you, if you can't hear each other, the Saskatchewan voters can't hear you. Just briefly add your points that you want to sort of finish up with. Nice and brief.
Mr. Moe is standing hand over heart, promising this time he's not going to make your life more expensive. That's what he promised last time. We have a fully costed plan that's going to deliver relief faster, double the amount next year for families in this province.
Mr. Moe.
I would say the plan that the Saskatchewan Party puts forward is the largest reduction in income tax since 2008, which was the last time we removed 112,000 people off the income tax roll. You add to that 54,000 additional people being removed off the income tax, Saskatchewan will remain the most affordable place to live in Canada. That's the goal of the Saskatchewan Party, and it continues to be the goal of the Saskatchewan Party.
Thank you. Time's up for that debate. Let's turn now to CTV national reporter Allison Bamford for the next question. Allison.
Thanks, Marelda. Ms. Beck, over the last year, we've heard repeated concerns about class size and complexity, overcrowding, the pronoun policy, and now we're seeing increasing violence in schools. How are you going to create a safe learning environment for students in the public school system?
As a mom, there was nothing more that I wanted for my kids than for them to receive the best education possible. And that's what I want for all kids in this province. But that is not happening under Scott Moe and the SAS party. We've seen 15,000 additional students in our schools, but only one teacher. Scott Moe has put us in last place in education. And after 17 years, they've shown us time and time again how little they value public education. It's time for change. We've got a plan to invest $2 billion into our kids' classrooms, to hire more teachers, more education workers. We've got a plan to get us out of last place and get our kids the education that they deserve.
Thank you, Ms. Beck. Mr. Moe, your time starts now.
Thank you, Marilda. Again, with 250,000 additional people living in the province, they have brought their children, and they are in our schools. And that's why you have seen a Saskatchewan Party since 2007 increase our education budget by 53%. That includes 9% this past year, really an unprecedented increase, while our student population has increased about 18%. We're addressing classroom size by building new schools, 28 in progress as we speak, addressing and talking to frontline teachers about bringing innovation to the classroom to address classroom complexity. Per capita today, Saskatchewan people are investing more in education than anywhere else in Canada, and that is allowing us to build more classrooms, more schools, more teachers, more parental involvement in our schools, and more funding for the education sector.
Thank you. Now let's start our 3-minute open debate on the same topic.
Well, Scott Moe just told us that he thinks that classroom size has to deal with the physical size of the classroom. It has to do with the number of teachers we have teaching in the system. And the reality is, again, 15,000 additional students, one additional teacher. We have fewer psychologists. We have fewer supports for kids that desperately need it. And that means that right now in this province, there are parents who are being called midday in their child's school day to come get their children because they don't have the supports that they need to keep that child safely in school. Our plan is to invest in our healthcare system, or into our education system. It's a plan to undo the damage done by a decade of underfunding by Scott Moe and the SAS party.
The first thing I would say is, with respect to the NDP plan, is in their costing document, they had committed $2 billion to the education sector, and in their costing document had $200 million plus $200 million in year two, $200 million in year three, $200 million in year four. $200 million times four does not equal $2
billion. But it's a cruel
counting. It just certainly doesn't.
The
Saskatchewan Party, as I said,
year.
Has increased this last budget 9% as the funding to the school divisions, who then turn around and hire the teachers in our classrooms. Most certainly up 53% since we have had the honor of forming government, while the student population is up 18%. Thankfully, people are moving to Saskatchewan and their children are going to school in Saskatchewan. But what I would say with respect to the commitment that this government has to education is that, yes, we are going to build new classrooms for those additional students, and we are going to continue to increase funding in our education sector to ensure that we have the teachers and the EAs and the supports for those students and for their families wherever they are attending their K-12 education. This is unlike the NDP record, who, when they had the opportunity, closed a school a month the entire 16 years that they governed.
Kids in grade 12 today have only known cuts and underfunding because of your underfunding of the education system. It's ridiculous. You cannot drive
9%.
Where we need to go if you keep looking in the rearview mirror, Mr. Moe. Now, our plan is fully costed. And let me tell you, it's accrual. It's $200 million the first year, then add $200 million the next year, and so on and so on. It's $2 billion. It's fully accounted for. It's no wonder you can't balance a budget, and it's no wonder that kids in our province are not getting the education that they need. We know how important this is.
It's short, $1.2 billion. That's the question for the NDP
Canada. You can keep saying that, Mr. Moe, but it's not true. The reality is your record is underfunding our kids' classrooms. It's robbing kids in this province of the ability to get the education that they need, that we need them to have.
Our record is 100 new schools and a 9% increase.
Time's up, leaders. Let's go back to CTV's Allison Bamford for her next question.
Mr. Moe, Saskatchewan's economy relies on our wealth of natural resources. How would your government ensure that economic growth is shared with all Saskatchewan residents, including rural and remote communities and Indigenous people?
Well, I think you're seeing that happen today, and I would point most recently to a co-investment by Indigenous communities and Indigenous people with a forestry company on an over $500 million investment in the Prince Albert area in an OSB plant right there. I would point to Chief Bobby Cameron's comments when we partnered with SEGA on bringing our gaming framework online, as he called it. This is economic reconciliation in action. I would point to the potash industry, the mining industry more generally, and the partnerships that they have and the procurement targets that they have on ensuring that as Saskatchewan economy grows, and it has, tripled, as a matter of fact, in the last 15 years, that it is there to benefit everyone across the province, and that is the case today.
Thank you, Mr. Moe. Ms. Beck, the same question.
Saskatchewan people are worried about the economy. And contrary to what Mr. Moe just said, it is not benefiting all areas, all sectors of the province. We've seen decline in seven sectors of the economy under Scott Moe and the SAS party. We've seen 40,000 jobs lost in rural Saskatchewan, 1,000 businesses outside of Regina and Saskatoon. We've got a plan to attract new investment and create good jobs, to revitalize downtowns and main streets. Rebates on the PST, the construction labor that Scott Moe stuck the PST on, and attracting value-added jobs here to the province. We need an all-of-the-above approach that ensures growth in all sectors, in all areas of Saskatchewan.
Thank you, Ms. Beck. Now let's set the clock for 3 minutes and start the open debate. Again, a reminder that basically, what is your plan that's going to benefit everyone, not just those in major centres or southern Saskatchewan?
So our plan is our plan for growth, of which we are on our second iteration and a view of what our province looks like in the year 2030. And it is working, as today what we see is we have the second lowest unemployment rate in Canada. 17,000 jobs have been created just this past year. We have the highest rate of growth for private sector investment into any province across the nation of Canada. Inflation is at an all-time low due to us rejecting the Trudeau NDP carbon tax on how we heat our homes in this province. And you are going to see more of the same in the future. A provincial government, should we form government on October the 28th, you will see a provincial government that will attract that investment from abroad and from within Canada, ensure that that private sector investment is creating jobs in the areas where we have strengths, the mining sector, the oil and gas sector, the forestry sector, all sectors that were not even mentioned, didn't even garner a mention in the NDP platform. Another question for your NDP candidate when they come to your door, but sectors that are employing tens of thousands of people across this province, we're seeing that investment land here today. We're seeing those jobs created today, and we're seeing all communities be a part of the great opportunity that Saskatchewan is facing.
I'll agree with Mr. Moe on this. There is opportunity in every corner of this province, but too much of that opportunity is being left on the table, and too many Saskatchewan people, too many communities are being left behind. Mr. Moe says he wants to run on his record. Let's talk about his real record. The worst economic growth in Canada. Second worst when it comes to creating full-time jobs. Second worst in economic growth. 5 years with 1.1% increase to the GDP in this province. Jobs lost, whole sectors of the economy in decline. That has been Scott Moe's record. Now, our plan is to attract investment in all sectors, in all corners of this province, to get our downtowns, our main streets thriving again, to increase small businesses, offering startup loans, and not doubling the small business tax rate as Scott Moe until recently had proposed. We need an all-of-the-above approach to ensure that all sectors in this economy are thriving and the benefits, the amazing opportunity, is available to all people in this province, not just a select few. That has been Scott Moe's record.
17,000 people getting a job this past year are not a select few. That's creating a job every 30 minutes. In fact, by the time we're done our debate tonight, there will be two jobs created in this province. I would say under the NDP, there was also a job created every 30 minutes, but the challenge was it was in Alberta and our children had to move there to get that job. Things have changed. Saskatchewan now is creating jobs right here by attracting that investment. That is going to continue should we have the honour of forming government on October the 28th.
It's time now to turn to Murray Mandrick, political columnist for the Leader Post and Star Phoenix. Murray.
Thanks. Ms. Beck, rural Saskatchewan is facing this age-old problem of shrinking communities and fewer farms. How can government address this?
Well, this is an issue that we see right across the country. But even in rural communities today, and I mean this, I see economic opportunity, I see opportunity everywhere. People, when they come, my dad's an outfitter, and when people come to our small town, they're amazed. One of his hunters bought the house next door. They want to see the kind of community that is present in rural communities right across this province. But in too many of those rural communities, the opportunity isn't available there now, and the services that people need are simply not available. What we see in rural communities
needs to be improved. Thank you, Ms. Beck.
That
is your time. Mr. Moe, same question.
We are so fortunate in this province with the rural-urban synergy that we have. Many of our natural resources are located in rural areas of the province. Our ag land, our mining products, our oil and gas. The people that are bringing value to those natural resources, they often live in our villages, towns, and cities, in urban parts of Saskatchewan. And here comes the synergy where those people add value to those products that are in the rural areas of our province. And so as we move forward and see the opportunities in mining investment, people living in in rural communities that are working in the mining industry, ag value added investment, people living in rural Saskatchewan that are adding value to our agri-food products. We are seeing successes like the export values going from $17 billion under the NDP to $50 billion today. That's wealth in our communities.
Thank you, Mr. Moe. That's it for individual answers. We now have 3 minutes for open debate.
Again, I'll agree with Mr. Moe that there is opportunity in every corner of this province, but the reality is that there are whole regions of this province that are being left behind.
One of them is the federal government.
That we are seeing job losses, business losses. Mr. Moe, that's not true.
It is true.
Well, it's absolutely not true.
We saw Jagmeet Singh come out a few weeks ago say he was not going to support Justin Trudeau.
Mr. Moe, people in this province right now want to know about jobs. They want to know about health care. They want to know about education. Mr. Moe wants to, he says he wants to run on his record, but we see him do everything but. He wants to run away from it. He wants to point to 20 years ago. He wants to point to everything else but his own record. It's time you took responsibility for your record, Mr. Moe.
When it comes to
opportunity in this province, we've seen small business losses. What we have a plan to do is revitalize those main streets in small town Saskatchewan to ensure that there are more small businesses. Startup loans, $40,000. That is something that will go a long way to create those jobs that are needed. But you know what else is needed in those communities? Services. Too many times in this province, kids in rural Saskatchewan don't have access to the services that are needed. Too many times, people drive up to their emergency room and see a piece of paper on the door telling them that they need to get in their car and drive down the highway to try to find services at the next town. This is not safe, and it is not working to attract the investment to small towns that we need in our province right now.
Small businesses most certainly need support, of which both parties have put forward, and they need less taxes and less regulation primarily. That is coming from a federal government of which the NDP supported and have propped up for the last number of years. The NDP, very recently, Jagmeet Singh said, we're not going to support Justin Trudeau anymore. That lasted 2 weeks, of which at that time he had an opportunity to go into the House of Commons and to not support Justin Trudeau, to support a carbon tax, which would save small businesses across
Canada. We're in a provincial debate right now.
So very much. But he chose not to. He supported Justin Trudeau again, and he supported the carbon tax, and he's costing Canadians, including those that live in Saskatchewan, money.
And this is where Mr. Moe focuses his time. I've been very clear when it comes to any federal leader. Doesn't matter the political stripe. If there are programs that are put forward that stand to benefit people in this province, I will be at that table making sure we get the best deal possible for people in this province.
What did you say to Jim?
And if there are instances where they're making policy decisions that hurt people in this province, hurt the economy, you bet, regardless of political stripe, I will be at that table standing up for Saskatchewan. My focus is on the people of this province and getting the services that they need, getting the supports, getting the economy going in all sectors.
The table
something
you went
that is
to
not
was
happening
the campaign
under Scott Moe and the
Justin
SAS party
Trudeau
right now.
Thank you, leaders. That's it for that open debate. Let's go back to Murray for another question.
Thanks, Brother. Mr. Moe, the NDP and the SAS party have very different ideas about how to spend our money when it comes to policing and public safety. The SAS party wants to have a marshal service. The NDP wants to hire more RCMP officers. Can you tell us how your plan is better?
Yeah, most certainly. Safer communities and neighbourhoods are a focus of this the Saskatchewan party, and we're committed to ensuring that a family would be able to go for a walk in the park after supper, for example, and feel safe in their neighbourhood. That's what we are seeing across Canada when it comes to higher crime rates, higher rates of vandalism, higher rates of homelessness. The root cause of all of this is addictions and the drugs that are available in our community and in our nation, and those drugs are nothing short of poison today. That's why you've seen a government focus on recovery opportunities, building 500 intensive recovery beds, also adding 500 police officers, including RCMP officers, municipal officers, and yes, the Saskatchewan Marshal Service to keep your community safe wherever you live in this province.
Thank you, Mr. Moe. Ms. Beck, your 45 seconds starts now.
Right now, Mr. Moe's record is that people in this province, too many of them, don't feel safe in their own homes, in their own communities. People should feel safe to be downtown, but too often they don't. Now, Scott Moe and the Sask Party, they like to talk tough about crime, but their record speaks for itself. The highest rate of violent crime, domestic violence in the entire country. It's no wonder. Mr. Moe can't even control the crime in his own team. One of his MLAs charged in a human trafficking sting, another charged with assault and choking. We've got a plan to get tough on crime and tough on the causes of crime, to put 200 additional officers on the ground now and address the issues that create crime in the first place.
Thank you, Ms. Beck. It's time for the open debate on this question. 3 minutes starts now.
Tough on crime doesn't work. That's a quote from your NDP candidate on Twitter. Tough on crime doesn't work. That's the NDP.
Tough on crime, tough on the causes of crime. That's a quote from the leader of the NDP,
Mr. Moe. Which is why we're building 500 recovery spaces across this province. This is a focus on recovery and offering recovery, access to that recovery through urgent care centers, through our complex needs shelters, ensuring that people that have unfortunately succumbed to a life of addictions have an opportunity to find a recovery space, and we're building that capacity today. This is very, very different because you see the NDP is a party that has shown in this nation that they will actually look at making drugs easier to get and recovery harder to get. Well, that's not what the Saskatchewan Party is focused on. The Saskatchewan Party is focused on making recovery easier to get, and making drugs harder to get. And that's why, since 2011, we have committed to over 500 police officers. 192 police officers since 2011, 180 committed to recently. 100 municipal officers committed to recently, and 70 provincial marshals to keep your community safe and to get the drugs out of the hands of the drug dealers and to get the drug dealers out of our communities. We are committed to recovery, and we are committed to enforcing the laws that we have in our communities, and we're committed to strengthening those laws.
I'm going to interject here. A key part of your platforms that are very, very different is the Marshal Service versus RCMP. Can you each briefly elaborate on those two very different platforms that I think voters want to hear about? Yeah.
Now, Mr. Moe is acting like he's just heard of the mental health and addictions crisis in our province. An issue that grew under his watch. People don't feel safe in their communities today. They haven't for a long time. Double the rate of violent crime when compared to the rest of the country. Scott Moe's plan in 2022 was to create a brand new police force, a marshal service, that would deliver boots on the ground in 2026. A plan that has already cost people in this province $14 million, and we don't see a single boot on the ground. This is a concern to frontline police officers, those in the RCMP, municipal police forces. This is a concern that had almost 100 municipal governments sign a letter asking for Mr. Moe to shelve this plan or to look at it again. Now, Mr. Moe, when faced with this reality, does what he always does. He took a shot at frontline RCMP officers in this province. We believe in our frontline police officers, our municipal forces. We think they need resources today. That's why we've got a plan to invest that money, half of it into more police officers and half of it to address the root issues, the issues that are causing crime in the first place, mental health and addictions concerns. Mr. Moe's plan to make a plan isn't working.
I'm going to interject here, Mr. Moe, briefly, your state on this.
500 recovery spaces for those that have unfortunately succumbed to a life with addictions and making those available. 500 police officers, we believe it's an all of the above approach, over 300 RCMP officers, over 100 municipal officers, and 70 provincial marshals to support our municipal police forces and to support our RCMP officers. The NDP will cut the number of police officers and offer to buy you a doorbell camera, not gonna help.
That's the all the time we have for that debate. Our last member of the panel tonight is Global News anchor, Brendan Purdy. Brendan, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Marilda. Ms. Beck, since the pandemic, addictions have impacted many different avenues throughout our province, whether it's overdose numbers, homelessness, mental health services, and even the overcrowding of our emergency rooms. Yeah. My question to you tonight, how does your platform address the concerns of Saskatchewan's most vulnerable people?
We have seen a record number of overdose deaths in this province year over year. And this isn't a new problem. What we haven't seen is action by Scott Moe and the SAS party to actually deal with the root causes of crime, actually deal with keeping people safe and alive so that they can access the help that they need. We've seen cuts to healthcare. We've seen cuts to education and counselors available there. We've seen cuts to service after service that help people recover from addictions early, not when it gets to the point that they're on the street, when they are losing their lives. We need to invest in the root causes of addictions, something that we haven't seen Scott Moe and the SAS party do.
Thank you, Ms. Beck. Mr. Moe.
I would like to speak to something that's already in place. 500 police officers, yes, to make our community safer and our downtown safer. 500 recovery beds. Part of that is capacity, which is the 500 beds. But part of it is access to those beds, whether it be through urgent care centers or through our complex needs shelters, which today have taken 400 people off the streets before they harm themselves or someone else. And I would hope that all Saskatchewan people can resonate with this fact. For 95% of those folks that have been taken off the street because they may be in a state where they're going to harm themselves or potentially harm someone else, 95% have self-referred to some type of addiction services. It is the government's job to provide an opportunity for everyone that may be living a life with addictions. Recovery is the focus of the Saskatchewan Party, and 95% self-referral rate is a positive step forward.
Thank you, Mr. Moe. Let's turn now to 3 minutes of open debate.
I'm not sure that Mr. Moe understands when people self-refer, when they look for help, what happens in our province too often. People are told there's no help for you. Phone back again tomorrow. Phone back again tomorrow. I was just talking with parents who had lost a loved one to overdose. And they said, you know how hard it is when you're in the throes of an addiction to be told time and time again you need to wait. Phone back again tomorrow. This is the reason we see record numbers of overdose deaths in this province. What parents like those have told me they need is supports, early supports for their kids, for their loved ones who are dying. What they don't need is empty, divisive rhetoric like we see from Scott Moe and the SAS parties.
I agree supports need to be necessary, and I don't think committing to the capacity of 500 intensive recovery beds is in any way rhetoric. I believe that is a service and a needed service for, unfortunately,
it is part
family
of the solution,
and friends
Mr.
that
Moe,
may have
but it is
succumbed
not the only
to addictions.
Solution.
This is what a
this
government
is not
needs
a
to provide,
problem.
Is not only the capacity.
Simple solutions aren't going to work. You need to engage all of those parents, those communities, those who have lived a life of addictions to understand what's needed to turn this around. We are losing young people at a rate that has actually decreased our life expectancy in this province. This is not a simple one-size-fits-all solution. We need to keep people in this province alive so they can access care. We need to prevent them from getting into care, into a life of addictions in the first place, something that is very hard to do when we see cut after cut to our healthcare system, to the supports needed in schools, cuts to mental health and addictions. This is a problem that requires all hands on deck. It requires being creative with solutions for sure, but it doesn't need more empty, divisive rhetoric. That's not going to help. That's not going to keep people alive in our communities.
Again, I would say 500 intensive recovery beds, committing to building that, over 200 built today, is not in any way rhetoric. That is a
Mr.
commitment
Moe,
that this party has to you, the people of Saskatchewan, and providing access to those recovery beds for those that need it. And all too often with the poison and the drugs that we see on our street today, it's not a community away. It's impacting our community, our friends and our family, and we owe it to provide them a pathway to a recovery and to a better life. We also need to ensure that the access points are there. And I explained the access point of an over 95% self-referral rate of people that are being brought into a complex needs shelter, being brought off the street by a police officer because they may harm themselves or someone else, are referring for addictions. They're reaching out for help. And we are going to, should we form government on October the 28th, ensure that we can provide those 500 intensive recovery beds across this province, partnering with Indigenous communities to do so.
That is the end of that debate. Now, with our last question tonight, let's go back to Global's Brendan Purdy.
Thanks, Mr. Moe. You both brand the other as being fiscally irresponsible. My final question of this evening is simple. How can the people of Saskatchewan afford either of your plans without falling further into debt?
Well, as I said, the last two budgets by the provincial auditor were balanced in this province, and we have put forward a fully costed plan like we do each and every election to balance the budget, in this case, by 2027. What I would say with respect to the opposition's plan is they have a $3 billion gaping hole in the platform that they had put forward. It's missing $800 million of revenue. It's missing $1.2 million in their education commitment, $685 million in their health commitment. That is not the Saskatchewan Party's record. That is the NDP's record, a record of decline, loss, and closure that is going to bring us back to increased taxes. And I would say this, the NDP don't have a plan for it to pay for it because they don't intend to. You will.
Thank you. Ms. Beck, your turn to respond.
How do I know that we can pay for it? Let's talk about records here. Again, last time Mr. Moe was on this stage, he promised that he was going to make life more affordable, he was going to lower power bills, and he was going to balance the budget. Mr. Moe has added more debt to the people of Saskatchewan than any other premier in the history of Saskatchewan. He's done it in a record 6 years. Our plan is fully costed. It's going to take us 4 years to get there, but we're going to balance the budget at the end of 4 years. Because the reality is, we can't afford not to make these investments in healthcare and education. Our plan, again, fully costed and supported by Ron Stiles, someone who served as DM finance in this province, served a number of premiers in this province.
Thank you
our
so much, Ms.
versus
Beck.
His.
You both brand the other as being fiscally irresponsible. So how can Saskatchewan people afford either of your plans without going further into debt? 3 minutes on this final debate starts now.
The last two budgets were balanced.
Mr. Moe, it took an invasion, Russian invasion of Ukraine, to balance.
Oh, in that budget year, we paid $2 billion down in debt.
It took that. This year, Mr. Moe has overspent.
That was an industry that you didn't mention in your platform.
Mr. Moe has overspent his last budget already by $2 billion. How are we going to do it? We're going to focus on the things that matter most to Saskatchewan people. We are not going to see overruns and mismanagement of major projects like the AIM system, something that's going to cost people in this province three times its original cost, still doesn't work, and has our hospitals in even worse condition than when it was put in. We understand the need to grow the economy in all sectors. As I said, there's opportunity everywhere in this province, but too much is being left on the table by Scott Moe and the Sask Party. We've got a plan to ensure that we're getting best value when we're making investments in infrastructure in this province, that we are giving full value to Saskatchewan workers and Saskatchewan companies. We know what is most important to the people of this province. I am very proud to be a Saskatchewan New Democrat. I am very proud of our record when it comes to balancing budgets, when it comes to delivering services for people in this province. Mr. Moe has a different view. Mr. Moe thinks nothing of sending his ministers on sightseeing tours of Paris, for example. His finance minister thought nothing because she was tired of spending $3,000 for what should have been a four-hour car ride. This is about priorities. This is about growing the economy. This is about investing in the things that Saskatchewan people rely on. That's not been Mr. Moe's record, and he's got the looming record deficit and debt in this province to prove it.
The last two budgets were balanced. The platform that the Saskatchewan Party has put forward has tax cuts for everyone in the province versus a temporary gas tax rebate, which will be less and will exclude people that don't drive in this province. We have a permanent tax cut. Theirs is a temporary tax gift. Our plan is fully costed. Their plan not only has an $800 million revenue hole in it, in which a U of S economist cannot find where those dollars would come from, but a $3 billion expense hole as well. The Saskatchewan Party will work to leave more money in your pocket. We'll leave more money in your pocket by reducing your taxes. And 3/4 of the platform that we have put forward is leaving more money in your pocket so that you can spend it. The NDP is going to take that money from you so that they can spend it. That's the significant difference that you will see here this evening.
31 tax increases in one budget. That is Mr. Moe's record. And he left a huge hole when it comes to our kids' education and the health care the people in this province need.
Thank
it's about
you,
priorities
both.
And investing and the things most important to Saskatchewan.
Thank you both. It's now time to wrap things up with closing statements from each leader. Let's start with the NDP's Carla Beck. You have 2 minutes.
Thank you, Miralda. Thank you to the panelists. And thank you to everyone who's watching and listening at home tonight. I'd also like to thank Mr. Moe for his service. I'd also like to thank all of the people over the last number of months who found the courage to come forward with their stories. Stories that weren't always easy to hear. There were stories of pain, stories of frustration, stories of a government that has simply allowed Saskatchewan people to go without the care that they need. People are fed up. They're saying enough is enough. And they're saying it's time for change. This election, you have a choice. I think this debate made that choice very clear. You have a tired and out-of-touch government that plans to see further cuts to education and healthcare. A government that time and time again tells you that everything is just fine, but you know better. And Saskatchewan, you deserve better. We've presented our vision to get Saskatchewan out of last place. Together, we can fix healthcare. Together, we can make life more affordable for you and your family. And together, we can build a strong economy for everyone. This isn't about Team Orange versus Team Green. This is about Team Saskatchewan. And it's time for change. This election, I'm asking for your vote to fix healthcare and to make life more affordable. Together, we can deliver that change, and we can build that brighter future for everyone who calls this beautiful province home.
Thank you, Ms. Beck. For the final statement of the night, we go to Saskatchewan Party leader Scott Moe.
Well, thank you very much, Miralda, and thank you to the panel, and thank you to all that have joined us at our provincial legislature this evening. Tonight, you heard two very different plans for our province of Saskatchewan. The Saskatchewan Party plan for a strong economy and a very bright future, and the NDP plan that will mean higher taxes for you, and it will mean decline, loss, and closure for our province, just like the last time the NDP formed government. Our plan will make life more affordable for students, for seniors, for homeowners, for families, and for everyone that lives here. By reducing your taxes, leaving more money in your pockets for you to spend. The NDP plan is going to take your money so that they can spend it. Our plan will keep our economy growing, more jobs, more opportunities, more investments, and more export opportunities. All of these things make our Saskatchewan community stronger. The NDP plan will simply take us back to a time of decline, loss, and closures. Losing people, jobs, and opportunities to other provinces. Closing schools and hospitals and raising your taxes, just like the last time they were in government. So you have an important choice to make on October the 28th. Saskatchewan is a great province, and we have come so far together in the last few years. There is more work to be done for sure, and the Saskatchewan Party has a plan to get that work done. On Election Day, I hope you will vote for a strong economy and a bright future with the Saskatchewan Party. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Moe. Election Day is October 28th. Advance voting starts next Tuesday. You can also vote by mail. Just go to elections.sk.ca and register by Saturday. That is all the time we have for the 2024 Saskatchewan Leaders Debate. To the leaders, thank you for enthusiastically debating your ideas tonight. I truly believe the voters of Saskatchewan appreciate this kind of respectful debate here in the legislature. Thanks to our panelists from our media consortium, CBC, Global, and CTV, and for asking some really important questions tonight. And a big shout out to everyone behind the scenes who made this debate possible. Thank you. I'm Merelda Fiddler-Potter. For all of us at the Broadcast Consortium, Thank you for watching, and good night.